I am Hayden Dingman, and I am here today to talk with you about a mouse pad, of all things. Those of you who have read the site for a while might know that I've been pretty dismissive of the RGB mouse pad trend. That's the Razer Firefly. Corsair makes one. I don't remember who else. I think they're kind of dumb, and you know, $70 for a mouse pad. Most people that I know don't even use mouse pads nowadays, so it seems like a tough sell. But that is not what we have here, despite the presence of one RGB LED zone right here in the top. This is Logitech's Powerplay mouse pad, and these other pads over here are also part of it. And then we have two mice, the G903 and the G703. We will get to those later. The gimmick here is this is a mouse pad that will charge your wireless mouse while you are using it. So this is the actual heart of the pad right here. It's a rubber base, picks up dust and stuff very easily. Kind of gross actually, but luckily you will never see this again because we have these two pads over here. You can tell my preference by looking at the wear marks on this cloth one. But yeah, we have a cloth pad, we have a hard pad. Either way, you just take it, you slap it down on top, and voila, you have a mouse pad. I haven't been using the hard mouse pad as much, mainly because when you get it on here, it's pretty thick, and this edge is very rough, and it just kind of like slices against your arm if you're making these movements all the time. I'm not a huge fan, but I know some people really like the hard surface, so it is there if you want it. But I've been using this nice floppy cloth pad, much softer on the wrist as you're making those big motions. And we are currently paired up with this G703. The way that this works, or the way that the power play works, is you'll see there's this little disc right here in the bottom. And push on that, pop it out. This is the actual, they call it the power core, but really it's just a big magnet. This works by inductive charging, and so those two metal contacts you see are both the magnets holding it on and the contacts that charge the device. And so as soon as that goes in, you are actually paired with the charging part of the mouse pad. Those antennas for the charging bit are in that rubber base. I don't think that we have enough light in here to see them, but if you hold it up to a light, you can actually see them running through here. They're like around in here, and that field that they're generating, this is a proprietary system, so that's different from Corsair. Corsair is using the Open Qi charging system. Logitech has a proprietary system. I asked them why when they first showed this off to us, and it's because their system actually covers this entire mouse pad. There are a few small dead zones right around like here. If you're using this like right in the bottom corner or like this bottom corner, you tend to not get a lot of charge, and sometimes it'll actually drop charging entirely. But generally, as long as you stay in this area, you can use this mouse as much as you want, and it's still going to be charging the whole time. You tend to get 1 or 2% charge per hour, so it's very slow, obviously, much slower than just plugging the device in directly. And you can still do that. We could unplug this cable from here, plug it directly into the mouse. This would be charged in an hour, maybe 2 hours, and you would have a full charge. But on here, you put it on the mouse pad, you leave it. I've been using both of these mice now for about like 2 months, month and a half, 2 months, and have never had them run out of battery. They have always been charged. They tend to cycle between 85% and 95%, which Logitech says they do to protect the battery health. But yeah, you can, you know, all times of day, all times of night. I've been using these 12 hours a day at home for, as I said, a month, 2 months, and still have a charge every single day. Takes about a quarter of a second to wake up the first time they use the mouse in the morning. But other than that, they're always responsive. The connection is actually going through this, so you don't actually need a separate, dongle for the mouse. The light, I think they call it light speed, is their proprietary wireless connection. That is built right into this big chunk of plastic on the top, and so your mouse is connected to that. You do have to pair that, and we can jump into the software here. You get this nice welcome to the team thing when you sign in. You know, you can jump through, change the lighting on the mouse, check out the charge. As you can see, we have 91%. You can see that it's charging right now. If I pull this off of the mouse pad, you'll see that change. Now we have 20 hours remaining on the charge. And then pop it back down, charging again. And then all you have to do to change which mouse you want connected is go over into this thing, say connect a different mouse, and it automatically turns this off. And then all they want to know is which one you will pair next. And it's as easy as turning that 903 on right next to it. And now our 903 is the paired mouse. So yeah, super slick. I don't know who's gonna have both mice on hand. We have both mice on hand because I'm reviewing both. Usually you would probably buy one. That is the big sticking point here. This mouse pad, the Powerplay charging kit, is $100 by itself. That's very steep for a mouse pad, obviously, though I think it's probably a better deal tech-wise than an RGB mouse pad for $70. The bigger problem, though, is that it's only at the moment compatible with these two mice. G703, G903, both of them brand new, came out the same time as Powerplay. Both of them have this disc thing in the bottom. If you don't buy them as Powerplay mice, or you're not interested in Powerplay, you can either have just an empty disc of plastic that's in there by default, or you can replace that with this 10 gram weight. And so you can add a bit more weight to the 903 or to the 703. Pretty easy to swap these out, obviously. So yeah, we can swap that 10 gram weight over to the 703, make it a little heavier, swap the power core over to the 903. Now this guy is charging. Very, very easy, very foolproof. But 703, $100, not too bad. In fact, I think that's pretty cheap for a wireless mouse, or at least a wireless gaming mouse. This does have the PWM3366 sensor in it, so it's the same as the G502, same as the 903. So it is technically a lower end mouse than the 903 as far as the price is concerned, but performance wise should be exactly the same. The 903 is $150. That is a very tough sell, I think. That puts it up with the Razer Mamba, I think is the only other wireless mouse that I can think of offhand that's that expensive. A couple of the others fall into that like $120, $130 range. So still more expensive than the 703, but not as expensive as this 903, which I think is a very, I don't want to say outrageous, but it's a little bit outrageous. But I can't say that this is not a nice mouse. It is an ambidextrous mouse, which is a bit weird. I would prefer just like a G502 shape, the right hand scoop type shape. But I do think this is a beautiful mouse. You have the magnetic buttons on the side, so you can swap out if you don't want the buttons on the right hand, you know, for a right-handed user, you can swap that out with this, and you can put buttons on the left-handed side. It glides really well. Same sensor, PWM3366, so really nice response. But yeah, if you want that mouse, you're talking $150 for the mouse, $100 for the mouse pad, $250 total just to use a wireless mouse without wires, which is, I think, a big ask. But I do hope that this technology catches on. I think that this is kind of the last barrier towards wireless mice being a mainstream thing. And you might, I mean, I'm sure some of you have used a G900 or even a G700 before, other wireless mice that have been popular over the years. It's not that wireless mice were like, I mean, they were terrible for a long time. Then they got a little bit better, but like there was always that hey, you have to plug it in still. And the, you know, you have to, oh, I have to take this cable that's just laying on my desk and plug my mouse in every night. Or you forget to charge it, and then you come back the next day and you start playing a game, and then, oh no, like right in the middle of my match tells me that I have 5% battery life and I need to hurry up and plug the mouse in before it dies on me. this is just like using a wired mouse. I've never, you know, in the month plus that I've been using these mice now, I've never had to think about it. It just sits there every single day. I leave it on the mouse pad. I come back in the morning, it's fully charged. I go away at night, it's fully charged. It just works like a mouse should work, which is to say, you shouldn't have to think about your mouse. You shouldn't have to think about like plugging the thing in every single night. So yeah, I think it's really amazing technology. There's another version coming out. Corsair has their version coming out in a couple months. I think they were originally trying to aim for the end of this year, but I don't think they're gonna make it. So probably early 2018. As I said, that uses Qi charging. The cool thing about that is if you have wireless charging on your phone, you could charge it on the mouse pad. The thing that's not so cool about that, this comes from Logitech, so they are a bit biased, but Logitech, when I talked to them, they did not seem to think that Qi charging was feasible if you want to cover a surface this large. And you can sort of see this when you look at the concept photos for Corsairs. They have like a hot spot in the top right corner. That's like the point where the charging is concentrated. And so at night, what you're supposed to probably do is like put the mouse on that spot. And then when you come back in the morning, oh, it's all charged. But that's a lot different from being able to use the mouse while it's charging all day. You can see like we've been sitting here and it's gone up to 96%, I'm pretty sure, since we've been sitting here charging it. So yeah, it's a really amazing technology, super foolproof. Easy to swap the mice out, easy to pair it with a different mouse on the mouse pad. And yeah, two surfaces, $100. We'll see if it catches on. This could be a pretty big deal for mice users. We might, you know, 10 years from now, the wired mouse might seem totally archaic, which is crazy because for years and years, I swore I would never use wireless mice because they were terrible. And here we are, G903, G703, and Powerplay.